Formerly known as the Large Herds Conference and now in its 42nd year, the name has changed with the times.
We've changed the name because the industry's changed. People got a very negative approach to lodge, and as we've listened this morning to speakers, perception is everything, people's interpretation, and so lodge is not a nice word now, not, lodge is not good, so we've gone to dairy business. This is what we all do. And in the last 42 years, the first conferences were about people that milked 300 cows, which was huge. Today we have people milking thousands of cows in multiple ownerships and all different structures.
This year's theme, drawing in big players to talk about the near future.
The theme of this year's conference is 2020. So what is the industry going to look like in 10 years? And we're covering things because in any industry, decisions we make today is what will make 2020. And so we've got inspirational people. We've had John Palmer, chairman of Air New Zealand. We've had Andrew Ferrier this morning. And these people are predicting where the industry is. We had Tim Grosner, a minister of trade for New Zealand. The big message we all got from this morning's session is we've got to take New Zealand along.
Farmers say the benefits of these conferences are not just with the speakers, but the listeners as well.
It's a conference that's been going for a long period of time, and it always has good stimulating speakers, but probably the real value is actually networking with people, you know, whether they be speakers or farms that you see every year.
I think what it does is it helps us firstly network with other people who are in the industry, and that's not only farming but within the greater dairy and agricultural industry, and of course there's a huge learning opportunity with that.
Andrew Ferrier, Chief Executive of Fonterra, announced at the conference that the company is looking into developing farms in both South America and India to meet increasing global demands for dairy products. Brian Beeston says the benefits of the conference are from people like Mr. Ferrier and others, challenging the current situations within the industry.
What we've got here is speakers that challenge your thinking, and so we've even had this morning where John Palmer says we need to train more governors to run Fonterra, because Fonterra board is made up of farmer directors. But the company is a $17 billion turnover. How does a farmer get the skill to run a $17 billion company? We need to put things in place. So he's challenging us to do those sort of things.
Glenn Holmes agrees, saying he's learned a great deal in just the first half day.
It's also the ability to sit back and listen to some challenging thinking and some challenges that have been already this morning put by speakers across the podium.
The conference finishes on Thursday. Scott Milligan, Country 99 TV News.